detailed. Okay? Type 1 occurs, it is mostly said that it occurs due to what? That the system or the body develops autoantibodies against the beta cells of islets of Langerhans or pancreas. Okay? It's a disease, okay? Disease that hits the beta cells. Of course, you are familiar with autoimmune disease, yes? And that's why type 1 is detected by the presence of a variety of autoantibodies, okay? Such as something known as insulin antibodies, okay? And glutamic acid decarboxylase antibodies, okay? What's glutamic acid decarboxylase? What's the function of this enzyme? When we remove a carbon dioxide molecule from glutamic acid, what do we get? Anybody? Raise your voice, it's okay to No. No, we get GABA. GABA. Okay? GABA. It's a neurotransmitter. Okay? GABA. Gamma amino type. Okay? We get GABA. And this part is very interesting. Okay, I'll tell you just a few words on it. It's not in your books. And you don't have to know it, but this is interesting because these specific antibodies are associated with a condition known as
do I lack insulin or do I not lack insulin in type 2? Okay. Okay. enough.
Insulin is there. Actually, it can work very well, but there is resistance to this action. Okay? Problems in the receptor or post-receptor events. Okay? So actually, the production is quite good. Even the production is increased to overcome this resistance. Okay? But then, at some point, if the condition is long-standing and there is no treatment, I develop type 2 diabetes, which at the end, the beta cells are exhausted. Okay? So there would be less production of insulin. But this is on the long course of the disease. Okay? But initially, insulin level in the blood is normal or even high. Okay? This is totally different from type 1, because type 1 I have no, I almost have no insulin production by the pancreas. Okay? How about treatment? I treat the cause. Type 1, I have no insulin, I provide insulin. Okay? How about type 2? Type 2 usually help insulin action. How do you help or enhance the action of insulin that is supposedly already there? You can control your diet, you do some physical activity, and you give drugs that help overcome the, which are the oral type of drugs. Okay? Overcome the resistance. And you'll notice next time. Okay? So this is concerning type 1 and type 2 diabetes. It's very simple. How about the other type of diabetes mellitus, which is gestational diabetes mellitus or diabetes related to pregnancy? Okay? This, of course, its onset is during pregnancy. Okay, surprise. And why do you think this happens? Because. Okay? Because the placenta produces hormones. Okay, no, the placenta produces hormones that oppose, okay, the action of insulin. This condition usually resolves after pregnancy, okay, after the cause disappears. However, a few women who develop gestation diabetes mellitus are more prone to develop type 2 diabetes mellitus. Okay? This is concerning gestational diabetes. Are there other causes of diabetes? Other causes. We said diabetes is a metabolic disorder characterized by hyperglycemia and decreased glucose tolerance. Okay? As I said, blood glucose homeostasis depends on the balance. The balance. Balance is the magic word in the body in general. And of course, in the cases of diabetes. Balance between insulin hormone, the hypoglycemic hormone, okay, which promotes glucose entry into the cells and its consumption, versus the anti-insulin hormones, okay? The bundle of anti-insulin hormones, which are hyperglycemic hormones, okay? And the balance between them is what makes the glucose homeostasis fall. Okay, so how about over conditions where there are overproduction of anti-insulin hormones? Yes? They increase, yes, in stress, maybe. Okay? Cushing disease or increase of cortisol, production of cortisol. A very obvious condition, I don't know what here actually, is the removal of the pancreas. No beta cells. Okay? No insulin. Diabetes. Okay? Another condition is hemochromatosis. Hemochromatosis. Heme, as you know, is iron. Okay, heme is iron. This is, to tell you a quick word about it, hemochromatosis is a disease, genetic disease, okay, in which there is increased absorption of iron. Okay, the body absorbs iron at a rate higher than normal people do. Okay, and then this iron is deposited in different organs, such as the liver, the heart, and the pancreas. Okay? Therefore, it affects their function or even damages its function in case of diabetes. Okay?
full burn cells.
Okay. And then finally we have drugs that may induce diabetes, such as diuretics. Now people who have hypertension, okay, they take what? They take diuretics. One type especially, the thiazide diuretics, okay? Thiazide diuretics. Oral contraceptive pills are also or may also be a cause, though not usual. And adrenergic agonists, which is people taking drugs, okay, that promote that relieve bronchospasm. You know, bronchospasm, asthma, bronchi, yes, okay, they have asthma, and so they take the beta adrenergic agonists such as dronabinol and salbutamol. Why is this so? What's the them, we can know what goes wrong and the complications. Okay? You don't things. So, first of all, we're going to take a look at an organ approach, organ-wise approach, okay? And of course, the organ that is mostly talked about would be the liver, okay? So what happens in the liver? Glucose uptake is decreased, yes? So therefore, glucose oxidation is decreased. Glycogenesis is decreased, yes? Centrifuge is of blood. The uptake is decreased also.
It's independent of this.
It's independent of the condition. Okay? So, so glucose oxidation decreases, glycogenesis decreases, and protein synthesis is decreased. Okay? Protein synthesis is decreased. When we talk about proteins, we talk about it in the liver, and we talk about it, of course, in the muscle. Excellent. So, there would be protein degradation. By the way, since we mentioned protein in the muscles, and what there will be a negative nitrogen balance. Yes? More degradation than the synthesis. Okay? Negative nitrogen balance. And this may affect what? Healing of wounds. Because healing of wounds depends on the production of proteins. Okay? Depends on the production of proteins. It's delayed. Okay? And people, of course, are more prone to infection. Okay? Going back to the liver, what are the metabolic conditions that are upgraded? Okay? Due to the action of anti-insulin hormones, the glucose. Glycogenolysis, okay, will be increased. Gluconeogenesis will be increased. Free fatty acid oxidation will be increased. Okay? And also, what follows free fatty acid oxidation? We have a surplus of what? Acetyl CoA. We synthesize, or the body tries to synthesize ketone bodies. Okay? Normally they are synthesized, but within, and they are present in the blood within a certain range, it increases. Because certain organs depend on it as a fuel. Okay? Such as the brain, which takes a few days to get adapted to the food. Okay, so free fatty acid oxidation increases, yes, leading to production of more acetyl CoA. Ketogenesis increases. Also, cholesterol synthesis increases. Okay, things that are related to acetyl CoA. And protein metabolism increases. Synthesis of plasma lipoproteins increases. Why? Because the liver is flooded with free fatty acids, which it wants to pack and throw back to the circulation. Okay, but its capability is less than required. Therefore, fatty liver may develop. Okay, fatty liver may develop. And the question here. Why are there free fatty acids in the liver? Let's take a look at the adipose tissue. The adipose tissue. Okay? We said that insulin promotes lipogenesis, yes? And prevents lipolysis through its action on the enzyme known as
hormone sensitive lipase.
Okay, this effect diminishes, of course, so lipolysis is increased, okay? And this whole thing is related to what is related to the body needs. That the body cannot find glucose or cannot consume glucose. So it resorts to oxidation of fatty acids, okay? And the production of ketone bodies, okay? So, in adipose tissue, as we said, glucose utilization decreases, lipogenesis decreases, and plasma lipoprotein its action is decreased, okay? Because this was also supported by insulin. The action of this enzyme is supported by insulin. Where is this enzyme present? Plasma lipoprotein lactase of blood vessels, okay? Of the blood vessels. So you cannot get confused, okay? plasma lipoprotein lactase, you are present in the epithelium of the blood vessels, especially in the and tissues and muscles, yes. And insulin promoted the action of this enzyme, okay? And it was responsible for what? Lipoprotein, okay? Degradation of? Yes, of the lipids present in the lipoproteins, okay? So the net result would be increased lipolysis and release of free fatty acids, which then are shunted to where? To the liver. Okay? So if you would like, you could begin with the adipose tissue. What goes wrong in the adipose tissue? And from there you can go to the liver. Because it would make sense. Okay? How about the muscles? Okay, they cannot consume, as I said, muscles. When we think muscles, we think two things. We think the proteins, because muscles are proteins. Of diabetes on proteins, on clay proteins, and the fuel. How about the fuel that the muscle used to get for its action? So because oxidation decreases, blood glucoses decreases, and protein synthesis decreases. Whereas the glycogenolysis decreases, metabolism, oxidation, and ketolysis. Okay. So. How about the blood? What do you think the picture looks in blood? Okay? Glucose is
increased.
Okay? There's hyperglycemia. Okay? Insulin, think that everything that insulin does, it is reversed. Okay? Normally what insulin does is reversed. That's why I suggest when you look at these metabolic changes, you first look at the... yeah, there's another table in the book that says what the influence of insulin on various pathways, okay? Take a look at both simultaneously. Not right now, so necessarily, but when you're studying, okay? Reverse these effects. We get metabolic changes in life. So glucose increases. Free fatty acids also increase, yes? Lipoproteins increase. And lipoproteins and it's what it carries also increase. Such as the triacylglycerol and cholesterol. And here there is a famous complication that develops. No, famous complication relates to the blood vessels. Atherosclerosis.
Atherosclerosis.
Atherosclerosis, okay? Atherosclerosis develops. And atherosclerosis carries another risk with it, which is emboli development and, when atherosclerosis develops, this is the normal lumen of the blood vessel, yes? Atherosclerosis, deposition of cholesterol esters and other lipids, what happens to more is like it is elevated, so the flow of blood decreases, yes? So it decreases, yeah? And eventually there may be development of what? Of thrombus, yeah? So closure of the blood supply. Blood supply means what? Means oxygen, nutrients, etc. Needed for the muscle. Therefore, yeah. Therefore, development of what? Muscle death, maybe like the famous condition of what? Myocardial infarction. This is why in a simple way put, when myocardial infarction develops, you may get strokes, okay? Because this happens globally, all around the body, okay? The arterial wall. Of course, I have to say here that not just one in the blood vessel is blocked that you get this effect, okay? So, you may develop strokes and so on, okay? So one of the famous complications that you should not omit or forget in diabetes are the what? Are its effects generally on the blood vessels, okay? Whether they are, this effect is on the big blood vessels, okay? Macro effects, big effects, okay? Or the small blood vessels, okay? The micro effect. Macro and the micro effect. And since blood vessels are affected, almost every part of the body may be affected, may be damaged, almost every organ, okay? okay? These minor vascular changes are maybe associated with infection of the retina. They depend on condition or retinopathy or neuropathy, nerves, okay? That's why the sensation in the periphery of hands and feet is affected in long-standing diabetes, okay? We may get retinopathy, neuropathy, nephropathy, affection on the kidney is a famous condition, okay? And when the kidney is affected, proteins that are usually retained in the body, they are lost in the body, okay? Such as the big proteins in the what?
Albumin.
Yeah, such as albumin, okay? So you think, when you're thinking diabetes, you think global. It's the whole body affected, okay? How about urine? What happens in urine? Since, of course, in diabetes, the urine pressure is how much is the urine pressure?
Like 180.
Yes, 180 watts.
Maybe the urine pressure is
limited. Yes, it's limited. Always limited. Okay, wherever there are units, please mention units. 180 milligrams per deciliter. Okay? In diabetes, glucose level may be raised above that. So it goes where?
In urine.
And where the sugar passes, what passes with it?
Water.
Yes. Therefore, these patients have a polyuria. When water passes, okay, stimulation of the body. The body is smart, okay? So it has to increase its, say, income of water. So what happens?
Thirst.
Yes. So polyuria and polydipsia, okay? Polyuria and polydipsia. And does water pass alone, or does it take with it some electrolytes? It takes some electrolytes, okay? Such as sodium and potassium, okay? And insulin, by the way, has a special effect on potassium because it promotes the entrance of potassium into the cells, okay? So this function is also disrupted in case of diabetes. And how about the proteins in urine? Protein and NPN. Non-protein nitrogenous compounds, okay? They may come from the breakdown of proteins, such as what? Urea? Creatinine? You know these?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think you took, but you're going to take them next level. Okay? Okay. And of course, ketone bodies, which are already elevated in the blood. We may have a condition if the diabetes is uncontrolled. Okay, we may have a condition called ketosis. And ketone bodies are acids. Okay? So the body may develop acidosis. Okay? The pH of the urine will be more acidic. The complications and the comas and so we're going to take tomorrow and the day after tomorrow. Okay? So I think we covered almost everything here. So the complications of diabetes, atherosclerosis, hypertension, infarctions, cataract is related to the eye lens, and we're going to take this tomorrow in here. Retinopathy, nephropathy, and neuropathy. So they may be related to, you can categorize them into macrovascular conditions, okay? The ones that affect they lead to atherosclerosis and thrombi, and which leads to infarction and strokes and so on. And the small blood vessels or the microvascular effect that is related, it's present everywhere. Remember, blood vessels are present everywhere in our body, okay? So a patient develops retina problems, nerve problems, and kidney problems. These are the most infamous problems of diabetes. Okay, I think we need today, I said, well, I'm not